goes up. So we're going to play Simon Says, and here's what I want you to notice. I want you to notice what you say to yourself the moment you go out of the game. Some of you are going to go out and do the shame game. Oh, you will. Right in front of me. You're going to realize that you made a mistake, and you're going to sit down, and you're going to go,
I am such a failure.
Some of you will feel bad because you went out. Some of you will go out, and you'll do the blame game. You'll cross your arms, you'll look at me, and you'll go, dude, it's your fault that I went out. Some of you will blame me for your mistake. Some of you, because it's your pattern, will freak out, you'll get mad, you'll get angry because you went out. Some of you will deny your mistake right in front of me. There's one point in the game where we'll all have our hands up like this. I'm going to say drop your hands, and some of y'all are going to go, no, I didn't drop my hands. This is just a twitch I developed. I do this from time to time. Some of you will deny your mistake. Some of you will quit. Some of you have developed a pattern of giving up too easily. Some of you quit too soon. Some of you will choose to act like you don't care instead of engaging, which is the battle that we're all doing every single day of our lives, the battle of apathy. So I just want you to notice what you say to yourself the moment you go out of the game. Simon says the game has begun. In order for you to play the game, I need you to stand up. So when you stand up, if you're standing up right now, you can have a seat. You're out of the game. You're out. Hey, you know what? Because Simon does appreciate it. I know you wouldn't have stood up if you weren't eager. And I appreciate that eagerness. And I'm going to give you all another chance. Simon says, everybody's back in. Simon says, stand up. Simon says, clap once. Simon says, clap twice. Simon's hands on your hips. Simon says, listen closely. Simon says, notice what you say to yourself the moment you go out of the game. Simon says, notice, is it shame, is it blame, is it freak out, is it deny or quit? Simon says, notice if you chose to quit before you actually begin. I'm not pointing any fingers at you, but I'm just saying, hey, that's a pattern that you've developed. And the pattern that you've developed says, hey, if I don't even try, if I don't even do anything, then no one can call me on the carpet. And just know that if that's your pattern, it's running you big time in your life. Simon says, clap once. Simon's clap twice. Simon's tap your shoulders. Simon's tap your head. Simon's hands up. Simon's hands together. Simon's hands apart. Simon's drop your hands. Simon's wiggle your body a little bit. Simon's stop. Simon's clap once. Simon's hands up. Drop your hands. If you drop your hands just now, you can have a seat. You're out of the game. Simon's drop your hands. Simon's clap twice. Simon's tap your shoulders. Simon's hands up. Simon's hands together. Hands apart. If your hands are apart, you are out. Simon's hands apart. Hands together. Oh, now you're out. Simon's look to the left. Look at me. If you're looking at me right now, you can have a seat. You're out of the game. Simon says, look at me. Clap once. If you clap just now, you're out of the game. See how we're doing? Say your name. Have a seat. You're out. Say your name. Simon says, say your name. A little louder. Now you're out. He's like, you don't know. Ladies and gentlemen, big hand for our winner in Simon Says. Simon's game is over. You may have a seat. Here's what I want you to notice. I want you to notice. Let's go back to the game. I want you to notice what you said to yourself the moment you went out of the game. Some of you, when you went out, you did the shame game. By show of hands, how many did the shame game? It's where you raise your hand. I saw you. I was like, as soon as he went out, he sat down. He's like, stupid. Folks, you and I have something in common. We do the shame game because we want things, because we want it to perform better. But the longer you live in shame, all you do is increase the chances of you not performing well in the future. Shame, feeling bad, doesn't change anything. Some of you went out into the shame game. Some of you went out and did the blame game. I saw you. Some of you sit down, you're like, it's not the way we play Simon Says in Iowa. It's different. You have a pattern. You have a pattern. Some of you will go in. You will go into an experience. You'll go into a sporting event. You'll go into a challenge in school with the idea already in your head, well, if it doesn't work out, I can always blame somebody else. Some of you, it is your pattern. Please hear me, eyes and ears. And it's holding you back. Shame and blame, they do you no good. If you want to blame somebody, oh, you can find somebody to blame always. Always, no matter what, you can always find somebody to blame. The only problem with it is it's very average. And I know in your heart of hearts you want to be more than average. I have a four-letter word that you can say to yourself every time you make a mistake. That four-letter word is going to make you feel better. Not the four-letter word that you're thinking. These guys are like, dude, I got a whole list of those. Not that kind of four-letter word. Four-letter word I'm talking about is N-E-X-T, next. What's the four-letter word? Next. When something doesn't go your way, you eagerly say next, you move on. When you're struggling with a project, you come up short, say next, move on. When your boyfriend, your girlfriend dumps you, next. Move on. Eyes and ears right here. Eyes on me, I want you to hear this. You're going to go through tough stuff in your life. Sometimes that's the loss of something that you really want to have happen in your life. Sometimes it's the loss of a relationship. Sometimes it's wanting to succeed so much and then coming up short. Sometimes when people fail and they experience shame and they experience blame, they come up with the other option. Well, hey, if I don't get into a holy, if I'm not super excited, then it's not going to really hurt me. But all you do by not giving your 100% is you hurt yourself. Some of you did shame, some of you did blame. Some of you, you didn't do it today. But you probably do it different times in your life. Some of you, when things don't go your way, you get so mad, you get so angry. He's like, dude, I'll take you out right now. Let me ask you a question. Is there some energy in this Coke bottle right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's real stuff, man. Anybody here ever been so angry, so upset that you felt like the contents of this bottle? Anybody ever had this thought? Come on, the next person, one more person, right? And you just feel like you're just gonna freak out on somebody? Let me ask you a question. If I opened this, would it make a mess? Yes or no?
Yes. Yes.
Question, please hear me. Please stay with me. Yes, it would make a mess. Here's my next question. Would I ever be able to put it back to the way it was, yes or no?
No.
Here's the deal, folks. We use anger, freaking out, as a way to control the people in our lives and the people that I love, that we love, because we've been taught to do it. Our culture has taught us that anger is an acceptable approach when things don't go our way. You've seen people in your life freak out, and in your mind you thought, it worked for them, it'll work for me. Let me just tell you something, folks. Anger, it changes people in the short term. It does. Freak out on somebody, scare them a little bit. But here's how it really changes them. Think about it this way. If for the next 5 days, I came in here, and I stood right here, and I shook up a soda bottle right here, and I opened it up right here, what would you figure out after about day two or three? Don't sit there. Well, it's so wise. And likewise, if you always freak out on the people that you care about, every time something goes, it doesn't go your way, you go, and you make a mess, what people will figure out eventually is this. Don't spend time near him. And if that becomes your lifelong pattern for how to handle the challenges in your life, how to handle the setbacks, the frustrations, if that becomes your pattern, the people that you love the most will eventually leave you. And it will hurt.